All right, guys, I've gathered the barbershop quartet here today to talk about Counter-Strike GO.
Let's go!
Between his legs.
Oh, in the face.
I think it's going to be a great way to have like a history lesson for these kids, maybe who are younger or people who just missed out on it the first time, to go back and look at some like really tried and true gameplay mechanics that are like hardcore ingrained in all of our, you know, senses.
Counter-terrorists win.
Basically, give these console players, people who haven't had a chance even, and they're going to play it on PC or whatever, we're going to give them the top five things they need to know before they go. Game modes.
Arms Race, I love it. If you were an old school Counter-Strike player, you remember a game that, you know, mod that was very similar, where basically every time you got a kill, your gun would kind of change into another gun and upgrade, I guess, back then. Now it's kind of top over, so where it's like a lot of powerful weapons are up front, and every time you get a kill, it leads you to another weapon until you eventually just come up to somebody with a knife. And if you get 26 kills and that last one's with the knife, then you win the arms race mode.
As soon as you shoot someone, your gun changes, and if there's a long animation cycle,
yeah,
you're totally effed.
Yeah,
on the
floor. I was saying that exactly to Ryan.
I think it's something to watch out for. The next one, Demolition.
I think it's like a team gun mode type thing. I'm not sure. I mean, we tried it really quickly last night, and it's like, it's still objective based and it's team on team, and like every time you get a kill you do progress to another gun.
Then we're getting into the classic mode. This was the first game, if people don't know, that really had like this paintball style game mechanic where instead of deathmatch, respawn, you sat out until your team either won or lost.
Classic casual, only real difference seems there is that I guess they got some easy stuff up front, like friendly fire is on or not on, right?
Oh, and you also get less money for kills.
You get less money for kills, and you start off, obviously, like you said, the big important one with body armor, right? So that's the one thing is for people that are looking at playing the game as it's meant to be played, right? I guess it's technically the classic hardcore. And so for that one, it's like, you gotta buy Kevlar.
You get the diffuser kit as well.
Oh, yeah,
it's
yeah.
like a small thing, but it's a pretty big thing because I think most new people won't realize just how good a kit is, like, and how much time it shaves
it's
off.
Half.
I think it's half.
It's half.
So instead of 10 seconds, it's 5 seconds. So classic casual, you're not gonna need to buy it. But if you're playing classic hardcore, you know, don't skimp on it if you have the money.
Plus, no blocking each other
in
the doorway.
I think that's a huge thing, the blocking. Because if you're playing like competitive match and you have the blocking, it can be a little...
Happened to me all last night. It sucks. It's like, run with your knife out.
Dude holding in front of the door.
That's actually another thing too. It's like, if you've never played, you do run faster with your knife out.
Oh yeah.
So,
yeah.
I mean, a lot of
everybody
people...
Everybody knows that.
Everyone knows that, but
well,
hey,
first time on
climbers.
Wait. What other controls do you think people need to know before they go?
Basically, Call of Duty, like whatever. You push forward and hold the trigger down and go, and there you go, right? Counter-Strike is more about like, you know, it's tactical. You gotta be, you know, very, very methodical about where you're going and what you're doing and how you're doing it.
You can't just strafe left and right and shoot at the same time. You actually have to stop.
Yeah.
Like, you have to go left, stop, right, stop. Like, when you stop, this is when your accuracy goes up, right? But then if you're actually moving, your bullets aren't gonna hit jack.
That's what bleeds into number three, mechanics of the game. Fundamentally, the buying mechanic. Each round, you start out with, you know, not a lot of money, and then you build it up as you go, whether you win or lose, kill, or, you know, shoot the hostage and lose money on accident. So yeah, that's actually an interesting comparison to, say, just global unlocks of weapons in Call of Duty. This is like, you have access to all the weapons as long as you can afford them in each match. What other mechanics are there that the console players need to be aware of that maybe they're not used to?
And that's the one question I'll just say it out loud right now. It's like, obviously on the PC, there was a trick to hit and crouch jump, and you know, it's like, you know, if you're trying to get some ledges and stuff, you had to hit crouch.
I think
you still do.
I think you still do.
There's a lot of bottleneck management in the maps. Everybody's like rushing to one area, or everybody's got, you know, a place that they will camp, and it's like death zone. You can't get through that door without getting shot. And the stuff, the flashbangs are really effective for this kind of stuff. So like, you might be tempted to just overlook buying flashbangs, but definitely get them. And what are the types
smoke,
of kit?
Smoke
good?
Is actually
there's
really
the new
good
ones too.
There's
the incendiary grenade and the Molotovs, right? Yeah. The Molotovs are really good for controlling those bottlenecks. It's like, you put that down, no one can pass through that. Basically.
Don't overlook smoke, because it helps you kind of get through some of those tight corridors.
Counter-terrorists win.
difference between coming from Call of Duty to this, especially for people who are way into whether it's Black Ops or Modern Warfare 3, it's like, you know, the difference coming from there to here, like the thing that just is hard for me to imagine, if you've never played Counter-Strike, coming into the environments that are in Counter-Strike versus the environments you're used to playing for Modern Warfare.
I think it'll be refreshing, which is weird, because that's how it used to be. But I think it'll be refreshing in that you don't have these giant maps anymore where you have to learn. It takes you like a week to figure out the map. Now, maybe a couple of games, you'll know the map already. The most important thing at the very top is knowing the maps and when you can actually put your knife down and pull out your gun. When you're supposed to pull out your gun, put your knife down, where you're supposed to plant the bombs, you know. And once you get in, you're going to start hearing people talking back at you. Like, you're going to start hearing those people who are playing telling you to go to A or telling you to go to B. And you got to learn that lingo right away.
The neat thing about Counter-Strike is once you understand exactly, you know, which route you can go, there is literally this timing that happens that you kind of figure out, and it's like, you know, from the start of the match to when you're going to get to this one point at this doorway.
The buying process in the very beginning. Yeah. So you only get like a couple of seconds where no one can move. And usually all those timings that Ryan was talking about are worked out from the moment you can move.
Yep.
So if you can get your buyout process really fast so that to the point where you can buy before you're even allowed to move, that's probably the best thing for you in the very beginning.
The weapons. There's tons of choices, but really, it comes down to just a few. Like, we're talking
Well, let's start at the beginning.
AK.
In the very beginning of the match, when you only have 800 bucks, what are you going to spend that
Deagle,
money on?
Deagle, come on.
Who's not? To me, there's two choices. It's the Deagle or the Dually.
The Dualies are pretty good.
Personally, I'm with the Dualies.
The Dualies are
more fun, but
you're
not going to
Deagle
for sure. Yeah.
In the last day or two, I've gone Dualies. Yeah. And then I've also gone Tech 9, which is like the terrorist kind of like 30 bullet pistol. And I don't know. The dualies seem better, at least right now, than they were before.
Do you have standbys you're going to every time, like AK, M4?
I mean, for me, it's always been like AK, M4. I don't touch the AUG or the SIG too much.
Let's go right to the sniper rifles. Like the AWP, you're going to see.
AWP is still strong as ever.
Yeah. Yep. It's the gun, and if you never play Counter-Strike, you're going to know the AWP, like soon.
Assuming you end up playing 5-on-5 at some point, which is how you truly play it, even though there are bigger maps. You'll figure out who kind of is your best opper, and you kind of either give them the op or you use the opper.
I love the old Counter-Strike. I'm excited for the new one because one, it's good, and two, there's a bunch of you guys jumping into it, whether on a PC or console, so it'll kind of breathe life into the community that I obviously love a game for. So, you know, yeah, lots of good fodder. I look forward to owning all of you.
I would say, you know, just like Ryan said, you know, play slow at first. I hate to use the word camp, but you know, if that's what it takes, learn the maps. Don't get frustrated with how the shooting works because it's definitely different. It's more realistic, of course, and you know, sometimes you are going to die and you just have to be patient.
But the hope is that people play it on console and they have a whole new experience that they weren't able to get on that platform. I just hope it doesn't go away like Team Fortress 2 did, because that's still thriving on PC. I'm really excited for this game.
Yeah, I mean, I'm super excited for this game. I have it. I've been playing it for the last couple of days already. But the biggest thing I can tell you is play as a team. Play as a team. And I think everything will take care of itself from there.